So hi everyone and very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of Government Schemes. In this session guys, I will bring to you another very important scheme from the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and that is Pradhan Mantri Annadata Aay Sanrakshan Abhiyan, which in short is PM ASHA. And I hope you all know this, we have started with the Government Schemes session for the upcoming NABARD Grade A examination and also the ARD Current Affairs session, and today this is the fourth scheme that we are going to discuss, right? So let's talk about the scheme guys without any delay, and this is very very important scheme. And yes, I have increased the depth in all the government scheme. Ab chahe kitni bhi depth mein aapse examiner question puche, if you are watching these sessions then you would definitely able to tackle any questions from the government scheme, right? So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you want to have the all round preparation of your examination, you can download the Anujindal app from the Google Play Store. So let's talk about Pradhan Mantri Annadata Aay Sanrakshan Abhiyan. So as always, we will derive the objective of this scheme from the name itself. So first of all, we will do those things that you can do effortlessly, and then we will move ahead to the things to remember. And there are very less things which you have to remember in this particular scheme, right? Pradhan Mantri Annadata Aay Sanrakshan Abhiyan. So Pradhan Mantri means Prime Minister. Annadata literally means the food givers. And who are the food givers, by the way? These are the farmers, right? So Annadata here means what? Farmers. Then I, what is the meaning of I here? I means income. Alright, I means income. And what is the meaning of Sanrakshan here? It is protection. Protection. So basically, this scheme is all about income protection of the farmers. The government is protecting the farmers' income by this scheme, which is known as Pradhan Mantri Annadata Aay Sanrakshan Abhiyan, and in short it is PM ASHA. But the question is how the government is protecting the farmers' income. For this, we have to go into the details of this scheme. There are three components of this scheme. After understanding these three components, you guys would be able to understand how government is protecting the income of farmers, right? So let's move ahead to that part. Of course, when we are talking about farmers, the ministry is the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Morena, right? So do remember the name of the minister as well. And now these are the three components. Number one component guys is price support scheme. But before moving ahead to the components, let me tell you that this scheme was launched in the year 2018. So you have to remember this. You have to remember that this scheme was launched in the year 2018. Very very important. Launch year aapko kabhi bhi nahi chhodna hai. You have to remember the launch year, right? Now let's talk about this first component, which is price support scheme. As the name suggests, the government is supporting the farmers by providing the prices of their crops. Now this scheme, this component is for three types of crops, which are pulses, oil seeds and copra. Do remember this, very very important. Procurement of pulses, oil seeds and copra will be done by the central agencies. Now which are these central agencies, by the way? So there are various central agencies, like we have NAFED, we have Food Corporation of India, etc. Right? So basically in this component, what government is doing, the government through its central agencies is procuring these three crops from the farmers and giving those farmers the prices for their crops, right? And do remember pulses, oil seeds and copra. The procurement expenditure and losses due to procurement will be borne by the central government up to a maximum of 30% of the procurement cost. Whatever be the procurement cost, 30% of that cost will be borne by the central government with respect to the expenditure, overall expenditure and the losses, right? Moving ahead, the duration of this scheme, the duration of procurement operations for particular pulses and oil seeds shall be for a maximum period of 90 days. Jo procurement period hoga, that is 90 days. While for copra, this period guys is 6 months, that is 180 days, all right? The Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare shall provide the working capital to the central nodal agencies to procure these crops. Of course, why would they spend their money to procure the crops? If it is a scheme which is being implemented by the central government, then the money should be provided by the central government, right? So that is why the Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare is providing the working capital to its central nodal agencies, right? And this department shall be responsible for reimbursement of losses as well, or you can say the central government, because this department here is being represented by, is representing the central government, right? So this department shall be responsible for procurement of losses of the central agencies up to 90% of the estimated loss, and the rest 10% of the losses will also be reimbursed after checking of their accounts, right? Moving ahead to more important points from this particular component. So this department shall provide also 1% incentive to the agencies on the net profit earned on the procured crops. Jo bhi crops procure kiya jayega, uspe jo net profit hoga, uska 1% will be given to as the incentive to the central agencies, right? And service charges are also provided, which is at the rate 1% on the MSP value of procured stock and 0.50% on disposal value, right? Now there is a provision of an empowered committee as well, which has the responsibility to look after the scheme, to look after the monitor the scheme, right? And that empowered committee is chaired by the secretary under the Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare, right? Moving ahead, central agencies shall release 100% of MSP value and 50% of incidental expenses to the state agencies within 3 days from receiving the stock. Now there are some more important points as well. So isse zyada detail mein aapse koi nahi puchne wala exam mein. So you can see how much details are being covered. Theek hai? So 50 bags of 50 kg each of produce shall be purchased from one farmer in a day. Ek farmer se ek din mein limit hai ki kitna liya jayega. 50 bags of 50 kg each of any particular crop, right? The overall quantity of procurement by central government will be restricted to 25% of the produce of that crop. Very, very important. This will be asked in your exam. ठीक है? जो पूरा procurement है, उसके ऊपर restriction है, वो कितना है? 25% of the actual production of that crop which is being procured, right? And the state or UT, if the state or UT governments wants to procure more than 25%, then they have to bear the expenditure of that procurement, right? Through their agencies only. And payment shall be released to the farmer within 3 days from the actual delivery to the procuring agency. 3 days ke andar farmers ko paisa chala jayega through the direct benefit transfer, right? So these are some of the important points of this component. I hope this is clear. Main ek bar fir se repeat kar deta hu, because thoda sa mujhe lagta hai ki confusion hua hoga definitely. So what government is doing under this scheme, let me summarize you this. Number one, the government is procuring these three crops, which are pulses, oil seeds and copra, through its central agencies like NAFED and FCI, ठीक है, and other central agencies as well. These central agencies are provided with 1% incentive of the net profit, ठीक है, they are also provided with the service charge. The total amount that the central government is procuring under this scheme is 25% of the actual production of that particular crop. These are some of the important points. Iske alawa, this department shall provide the working capital to the nodal agencies as well. Reimbursement of losses bhi kiya jayega by this department. Service charges we have discussed. There is an empowered committee under the chairmanship of secretary of the Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare, right? So these are some of the important points, guys, from this particular scheme, this particular component. Please do remember all the points, right? And now let's talk about another component, which is price deficiency payment scheme. Now again, the name says it all. The name says it all. Price deficiency payment scheme, which means the government is providing the amount to the farmers जो कि उनको कम मिला है जितना मिलना चाहिए था उससे. Basically in this component there is no physical procurement of crops involved. There is no physical procurement of crops involved in this particular scheme. So what government is doing under this? So government is doing the direct payment of difference between MSP and actual selling price of the crops जो कि farmer को मिला है, right? So basically let's say for any crop, let's say the MSP is 50 rupees per kg, right? And the farmer sold that crop at the rate of 40 rupees per kg. Then this 10 rupees wala difference, this 10 rupees difference is provided by the central government through this particular scheme, which is price deficiency payment scheme. And again, in this also, up to 25% of the produce, actual production, the price the deficient price of up to 25% of the actual production of any crop is provided by the central government. Above than that, the price has to be borne by the state government only, right? So this scheme is for oil seeds again. ठीक है, this scheme is for oil seeds only for which MSP is notified. याद रखना, this is only for oil seeds. The last one was for pulses, oil seeds and copra. However, this is only for oil seeds. State governments can either choose PSS or PDS. They have option of choosing between PSS and PDPS, right? ये दोनों points हमने discuss कर लिए. What government is doing basically, they are providing the difference between the MSP and the actual selling price of the crop, right? And there is no physical procurement involved. The implementing state or UT has to choose one or more oil seeds produced in their state only. Of course, इसमें तो कोई वैसी बात नहीं है. Of course, जो उनके state में हो रहा होगा उसी की तो बात करेंगे वो. UP वाला मध्य प्रदेश के oil seeds की बात थोड़ी करेगा, right? The entitled compensation will be paid to farmers within 1 month from the date of sale. This is very important. In the previous component, the farmers are getting prices of their crops within 3 months. However, in this component, the farmers are getting the deficient prices of their crops within 1 month, right? So please, there is a difference. The details of the agriculture produce, daily arrival, rate and all other details are provided on this portal, which is EggMarkNet portal of the central government. Do remember the name of this portal, EggMarkNet, right? And finally, the support by the central government is provided, as I told you guys, up to 25% of the produce. Beyond this, finances shall be borne by the state government or the UT government, which wants to provide the deficient prices of more than 25% of the produced crop, right? So this was the price deficiency payment scheme, and now this one, private procurement and stockist scheme. So the idea behind this component, guys, is that the warehousing requires the warehouse requires various techniques, like उसके अंदर कोल्ड स्टोरेज होना चाहिए, पेस्ट रेजिस्टेंट होना चाहिए, एवरीथिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड इन अ वेयर हाउस. ठीक है, सो अब गवर्नमेंट के पास इतने रिसोर्सेज, ऑफकोर्स रिसोर्सेज आर ऑलवेज स्कार्स इन नेचर, सो गवर्नमेंट के पास इतने रिसोर्स नहीं है कि वो इतने सारे हाईटेक वेयर हाउसेज को डेवलप करे. द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट डज नॉट हैव सो मच रिसोर्सेज दैट इट डेवलप्स द हाईटेक वेयर हाउसेज, राइट? सो looking taking into consideration this fact, the government through this component is inviting the private players to procure the crops and then accordingly sell in the market, right? So this component, remember, is also for the oil seeds. States have the option to roll out PPSS in selected districts on a pilot basis, right? The selected private agency shall procure the commodity at MSP in the notified markets. Yes, do remember this. Even if the private players are procuring the crops, they have to procure those crops at MSP only. Below this price, they cannot procure. ठीक है? And the maximum service charges. So these private players are provided with the service charges, which is up to 15% of the MSP. ठीक है? 15% of the MSP. This is very very important point. Do remember this. The private agencies will be offered facilitative business environment that is being offered by the state or the UT government, which are implementing this component in their respective state or UT. The state government shall exempt market fee levied under the respective Mandi Boards Act. जहाँ पे भी APMC Act है या Mandi Boards Act है, उसके अंदर जो भी fees लगती है वो exempt कर दी जाएगी. The private agency shall be responsible for all forms of handling, storage and transportation, and that was the objective behind launching this particular component, because government has the scarce resources and that's why they wanted to outsource this procurement process, and that is why these private players are now involved. The implementation of this scheme is being monitored by a state level monitoring committee, which is chaired by the chief secretary of that particular state. All right, so that was about this component, and that's it for the scheme. I hope, guys, this scheme is clear. Let's do a quick revision. So that the objective of this scheme is to protect the farmer's income, and how government is protecting the farmer's income with the three components, which are these. Of course, it is being implemented by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Under this component, government is procuring these three crops, pulses, oilseeds and copra, up to 25% of the actual production. If the state or UT government wants to procure more than 25% of the actual production, then they have to bear the cost, right? the central this is being done through the central nodal agencies, and the these agencies are provided with 1% incentive, service charges, reimbursement of losses, etc. Then we have second component under which the difference between the MSP and the actual selling price is provided by the central government, and again up to 25% of the actual production. And then we have the third component where the role of private players is there. In this particular component, the private players are procuring the crops at MSP and then accordingly selling it in the market, right? And the idea behind this scheme is to reduce the burden on the state governments or the central governments, right? So this was about the scheme, guys, and as you know, we are out with live course of RBSAB and NABARD. NABARD classes are already started. I hope आप में से कई लोग हैं जो कि NABARD की लाइव क्लासेस को एंजॉय कर रहे होंगे. जो लोग कर रहे हैं उनसे पूछिए जाके कि हाउ बेनिफिशियल दीज लाइव क्लासेस आर. ऑलराइट, एंड आई विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन टुमारो. टुमारो विल बी अ सेशन ऑन एआरडी करंट अफेयर्स. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग गाइज. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.